Problems on finding x and y when velocity is given as a function of time. Example 1. Given velocity as a function of time is equal to 4t cube minus 2t plus 1, and at t is equal to 1 second and x is equal to 5 meters. Find position of the particle as a function of time and acceleration of the particle as a function of time. Let us see this. Since position of the particle is velocity of the particle is given, which is equal to v as a function of time, is equal to 4t cube minus 2t plus 1. We need to calculate what is the position as a function of time and acceleration as a function of time. So what we can do? So velocity is equal to dx by dt. So from this what we can write, dx is equal to velocity into dt. So let us integrate on both sides. Integral of dx is x. Integral of v is 4t cube minus 2t plus 1 into dt. So x is equal to integral of 4t cube dt minus integral of 2t dt plus integral of 1 dt. So finally we will get x as a function of time. 4 integral of t cube dt is equal to t power 3 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 minus 2 integral of t dt is equal to t power 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 plus 1 integral of dt is nothing but t plus c, because it is indefinite integral. Therefore what we get, x as a function of time is equal to 4 t power 4 by 4 minus 2 t square by 2 plus t plus c. 2 get cancelled, 4 get cancelled. Therefore position as a function of time is equal to t power 4 minus t square plus t plus c. So we don't know c well. Since they have said at time 1 second and x is 5 meters. So for these limits, let us substitute here, we will get the value of c. So if x is 5 meters at the time of 1 second, so 1 power 4 minus 1 square plus 1 plus c. So therefore, so 1 power 4 is 1 minus 1, so they get cancelled. So c value we will get it as 4. Therefore, position as a function of time is equal to t power 4 minus t square plus t plus 4. This is the expression of position in terms of time. We also need to calculate acceleration. So acceleration is equal to dv by dt. So acceleration is equal to d by dt of velocity is 4t cube minus 2t plus 1. Therefore acceleration is equal to d by dt of 4t cube minus d by dt of 2t plus d by dt of 1. So finally what we get, acceleration as a function of time, 4, so 12t square, because d by dt of x power n is equal to n into x power n minus 1. So 3 comes forward, 3 into 4, 12, t power 3 minus 2, which is t square, minus 2 into d by dt of t is 1 plus d by dt of 1 is 0. So finally what we got, acceleration as a function of time is equal to 12 t square minus